Hey, you put your Skyrim in my Daggerfall. No. You put your Daggerfall in my Skyrim. Hello, welcome to Let's Play Skygerfall. This is a game, obviously, in the Skyrim engine, which recreates the main quest only of Daggerfall. I am Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick, and I'm playing this as someone who's just like, in real time finished Daggerfall Unity about a month ago. And now we're going to play this. This goes through the main quest only. There's no huge landmass. As far as I know, there's no guilds, anything like that. Side quests, procedural stuff. It's all left out here. So, this is other stuff that has nothing to do with this. The Creation Club. So we start a new game. I did walk around in the beginning room just to get a feel for it and the levels, the audio levels and everything. But I have not fought anything and I have not gone out the first door. Alright, so we're back to vanilla Skyrim faces in here, which is not the way I was playing, but that's okay. Now, I also installed some other things, SKSE, which you need, I'm told, for the Featherfall spell and jump, I believe. I don't know if there's a levitate or not. But you need SKSE for that to work correctly. So that's installed. I've installed SkyUI to change the interface around. Doesn't change this, unfortunately. And I also have installed a Daggerfall paper map. And there's some fixes and updates for the mod itself, which I've also installed. Other than that, that's it. I just thought about who I want to play. Funny because I never, maybe once, I used the dragon skin power to absorb spells, and I think I wasn't doing it right. Okay. So we'll change that and presets. No. Hell no. No. Alright, let's talk about this one. I like the skin tone lighter. I made the weight. Doesn't really matter, but you know, so boobs get bigger. I'll put the weight there. And that's it. I haven't thought of a name. Yeah, I never went for any of the dirt color war scores or anything like that. Nose type. Imagine if you were looking at someone and their face was going like this in front of you. Can I turn this character? No, that just moves. I can. Believe me, I learned from Mass Effect to look at the nose from the side also. I suppose. Oh, Jesus. Nose length. Length. Cheekbones. Really gotta look at the face closer than this to see, really. Oh yeah. A little swollen there. Check color. So hard to move this thing. There we go. Oh, I changed that. I'm noticing the themes. I'm noticing the dungeon themes, and I like it. Cheek color lower. Oh, down there. No, no, no. Eye shape. Probably gonna leave this as is. They're all crazy. I'm not sure if that's how it was. Turn to one side, see? Okay. So this is exciting, so I could directly compare. Oh my god, no. All the dungeons and everything. She's undead. Really need better lighting conditions for this. Hi, devs. Been forever since I messed around with this stuff. She turns. Which way does she turn? She turns this way? Alright. Eyeshadow. Is that too much? All right. Whoops. Yeah, this is not responsive. Brow type. Or no brows. Okay. Mouth shape. Yeah, they're all gonna be horrible except for the original. I know. Lip color. Always a struggle in games like this to make your character actually not look hard. How is that? Is that alright enough? And then hair. I mean, it could be covered up by a helmet anyway in the end, but... And plus, I primarily play in first person. So, hair color. I don't know. Is that good enough? And for a name, then what? was my random name generator. So... just trying to think. That reminds me of the first Alien movie. They might have got ideas from there with the original Daggerfall. Yeah, so I'm always calling my naming myself after gems and stuff. I think this time we'll just go with Crystal. Choose your class. Mage. Mage stone added. Okay. It requires a key to open. Alright, so... we have all this stuff already. Iron sword. Okay, I'm wearing noble leather armor, which is better than iron armor. There's a shield. Helmet, boots, and gauntlets. Potion of light feet. 10% harder to detect for 60 seconds. And then we got potions of minor healing. 5 of them. 5 minor magic, 5 minor stamina. 2 resist fire, and a potion of the warrior. One-handed weapons do 20% more damage for a minute. Okay. We have the Book of the Dragonborn, which is... gotta be the same book, right? So I wonder if there's anywhere we can sell this stuff, or we're just gonna be going from dungeon to dungeon. 10 lock picks, 2 torches. Okay. And here's my skills. I'm level 1. I got nothing. Oh, we see this map. Emperor's secret meeting area. Okay, world map. Alright, so this isn't... is it showing... I think it's just showing the Skyrim map at this point. It's definitely not a paper map look. I was just curious about that. And then magic. So I have dragon skin ability. Absorb 50% of the magicka. Maybe that's why I wasn't using it. Because obviously you want 100% of the magicka. That'd be awesome. But, you know. Also, we have flame spell, voice cracking spell, and health. 10 points per second. Flames do 8 points per second. Magic resistance. 25% resistant to magic. Mage skills improve. Oh, okay. So by choosing that at the beginning, that's really all we did. I guess it's 20% faster for whatever you want to do. Magic skills, thief skills, or warriors. You know, melee. And range, I suppose. Dragon skin. Alright. Okay. So that's the Emperor. This is Okado. Doesn't talk very loud. Should I be fixing that? Oh. I wasn't even trying to look at. My friend Emperor Uriel Septim the Seventh has sent me to Daggerfall to investigate the mysterious circumstances surrounding the death of King Lysandus, and to find and destroy a personal letter he sent to Queen Minasera, which never arrived. She's gonna talk to us about. It's the most gold I've ever carried in my life, man. All right, so settings. Let's put the voice up. Hopefully that's too much. Subject to change, of course. He just sounded very low, unless it's just him.
Yes?
Can hear him better now, right? Now, this voice is nowhere near as good as the voice done in the live-action cutscene in the beginning of Daggerfall. Just gonna put that out there right now. You wish to see me, Imperial Majesty?
Excuse the gloom, but none may know of this meeting.
Hmm.
The nature of my trouble is darker still. Over a year ago, King Lysandus of Daggerfall died honorably on the field of battle. He was as loyal a subject, ally, and friend as you are. I did grieve for him, but his spirit does not rest. With the spectral army, he haunts his former kingdom, crying for revenge. I do not know why a good and loyal man would be so cursed. Perhaps you can find the answer and close the marble jaws of oblivion, bringing peace to his soul. I ask this as your emperor and as your friend. I have one lesser request. Several years ago, I wrote a letter to the Queen of Daggerfall. It never arrived. The letter was of a sentimental and personal nature.
Lies.
If you find and destroy that letter, I will be grateful. Now my champion rests well this night, for tomorrow you sail for the Kingdom of Daggerfall.
Just doesn't have the weight of that performance, sorry. I mean, still a good reading, but if you watch that cutscene, I don't know who that guy is in the cutscene playing the Emperor, but great voice, great presence, everything. You wake and look around the room. Some hours ago you were in a boat en route to Daggerfall when a storm of supernatural strength boiled over the Iliac Bay like a malefic creature. Your boat was destroyed, but you managed to swim through the churning water to a promontory rock. There you found a cave and escaped the fury of the storm. Funny thing is, this cave is not near the water. You had only just lit a small fire when a mudslide sealed you within. Your fear of being buried alive calmed when you saw the corridor leading out of the cavern. Perhaps there is a way out of this cave after all. Once free of the cave, you can begin the Emperor's quest. Privateer's Hold. Escape. Basically part of what that text said. Alright, so here is our ebony dagger, and I did not even fill out the little questionnaire, because there is none. Iron gauntlets, iron boots, bedroll. We got beer, broth, 653 gold, 10 more lock picks, a potion of cure disease, and 3 more potions of minor healing. Cool. Okay. Well, we don't need to sleep. There's that. I wonder if you can sell these things. There'll be a place to sell them. Prisoner's cuffs. Oh, I'm thinking these are like handcuffs. So now we have 8 potions of minor healing. They're preparing us for this ordeal. 20 lockpicks. Oh, I wanted to look at this too. So the ebony dagger has the most strength. Well, damage anyway. Oh wait, can I enter? Wait. How do I make hotkeys? So I have the ebony dagger equipped. I also have a longbow and a bunch of iron arrows. Favorite. Okay, wait. So we're gonna go favorite. How do I can't move within the menu then. Okay. And I also want to favorite that. That's not it. Wait, here we are. Okay. I forget all this stuff. I haven't played the Skyrim for quite a while now. Okay, that's one, and that's two. Okay. Okay. And then how do I switch to spells, right? Favorite spells. So I favorite that. And I favorite that. That's the dragon skin. How do I get into that menu? Q, right? Okay. So this will be 3 and 4. At least for now. Healing is 4. Okay. Okay. So we're in Privateer's Hold. We must escape. The rat. The rat's in here. You a skeever? Rat meat. Is that the imp I hear? Cure disease. Minor healing, cure disease, minor healing. Whatever they are, they're apparently that way. I can't hide from you. Okay, we got an emerald. 100 gold, 4 lockpicks. Mort flesh? That's an ingredient. Mortified flesh, is that what it's supposed to mean? And another potion of minor healing. Well, they love giving us these. Huh. I can't hide from him. Okay. Apparently I am, though. Normally a bat would be over here, maybe that's what I was hearing. And then the thief would be down below. Now I'm hers. Arrow is sticking out of it. That's hilarious. Bat's milk cures all diseases. Ew. You won't get the best of me. I will not get the best of her. Right here. Not used to being able to see where the enemies are. Okay, there's an imp in here. This could get hairy. This thing's extremely noisy. Yes, use up your mana. Oh, you got me that time. Maybe it doesn't run out of mana. Whoops. Nasty little thing. Imp gall. Blessed iron dagger. I love the loot stashes, just like in Daggerfall. Chainmail gauntlets. 20 gold, iron katana, 4 lockpicks, and refined mithril. Cool. So the treasure would normally be inside one of these, I think. I mean, I'm not picky. I'm just going to point out differences, because it's fun. Now my mana's regenerating, which is really no need to sleep. This is where the thief is, I think. Maybe not. Sneak attack. Damn it. Still didn't see me, but I don't think it qualified as a sneak attack. Bear. Rat meat, yummy. Interesting statues. Keep reminding myself that I'm a beginning character. I'm level 1. Can't be one-shotting bears, but I think the thief is down here.
someone there.
Trying to stand up. Nope. He's an Argonian thief. I don't know if this is part of the soundtrack or the environmental sounds or whatever, but out of my left speaker I hear a ting-a-ting-a-ting sometimes. Oh, almost, right?
Yes.
Whee! Yeah, out of the left speaker. What else can I do? Potion of the Warrior. I only have one. I don't want to use it now, right? It kills us pretty quickly. I had trouble standing up at that point. Alright, run, run, stand up, run, run. I can't run. Stamina is low. Oh, the bat now? Like, we're fully seen almost here. Sneak increased. So he's already slightly damaged. We'll try to damage him some more. We'll probably have to run. Yeah, I ran far. Nothing in this thing's hand or lap, I thought there was. Yeah, this is tough. I wonder if he went back to his original spot or was just hanging around somewhere.